لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب ما كان حديثا يفترى ولكن تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل كل شيء وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكمالان على خير خلقه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Respected viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum. A warm and a hearty welcome, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, on another episode on the sublime pristine conduct of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the sublime pristine conduct of the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from Adam alayhi salam until Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those that will follow every example of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those that will follow the sahaba, you know, whichever sahaba it was, subhanallah, including the khulafa arba'a, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us love them. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make us among those who are the ahlul Qur'an. Allahumma ja'alna min ahlul Qur'an alladhina hum min ahlik wa khasatik. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among the ahlul Qur'an, among the people of the book, the people of the Quran al-Kareem, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen to be the, you know, those that are successful in the world, in the akhirah, and the special friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, tonight on the sublime pristine conduct of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we'll be speaking about the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as far as his character was concerned when it came to being joyful with others, smiling with others, and what kind of, you know, subhanallah, akhlaq and character he possessed. At the same time, how he portrayed his character to the rest of the people out there. Now, on the final, last episode, we spoke about the Prophet Moses, or Musa alayhi salam, and we spoke about, subhanallah, wherein his sublime, pristine conduct, was when, subhanallah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, rahimallahu akhi Musa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon my brother Musa, when he spoke about the entire incident between him and Khidr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Moses and with him another person go and seek knowledge from another person who was known as Khidr. Now we mentioned that Khidr subhanallah was a man that wherever he sat became green and lush. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or people called him Khidr in other words, because Khidr or Khidra or Khidra, Akhdar in Arabic would mean green. And wherever he sat became green and lush. And the entire incident which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about in the Quran al-Kareem, about, you know, Musa alayhi salam going out and seek seeking knowledge from Khidr, and how much of a hardship he went through. At the same time, when Khidr done certain things, then Musa alayhi salam could not take it. Because being a Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he saw wrong, he tried to stop it. مَرَّآ مِنْكُمْ مُنْكَرًا فَلْيُغَيِّرْهُ بِيَدِهِ. Whoever amongst you sees the wrong, they try to stop it with your hands. فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ. If this is not possible, فَبِلِسَانِ. Then try to speak out against this. فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ. If this is not possible, فَبِقَلْبِ. Then try to think of this certain thing as a bad action in your heart. وذلك أضعف الإيمان. This is the lowest form of iman, meaning a person who sees wrong and cannot stop this certain evil action. Thereafter, if he can't stop it, he thinks about it. You know, he talks about against it. If he doesn't think about it in his heart as a wrong action, this is the lowest form of iman. وذلك أضعف الإيمان. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who will try to stop it. If we can't, at least speak out against it. If we can't, then at least think of it in the heart as an evil action. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma thabbitna ala al-iman. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala keep us steadfast on iman. Wa amitna ala al-iman. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make us leave this world with iman. Wa ahshurna yawm al-qiyamah ma'a al-iman. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make us, wake us up on the day of qiyamah with iman. Now Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, respected viewers, remember, Islam speaks about every aspect of one's life. From the time we are created till the day we leave this world, every aspect of one's life has been spoken about. To such an extent that the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَوْ عَدَّهُ لَعَادُّ لَأَحْصَاهُ. That Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke so clearly that if somebody wanted to count the letters when he spoke, they could do so. So in other words, if we speak in that manner, bearing in mind how many people we are addressing in a congregation, over television, whatever it may be, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala rewards you for free. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards you on this. تَبَسُّمُ فِي وَجْهِ أَخِيكَ صَدَقَةً. To smile with your Muslim brother is a form of sadaqah, a form of charity. So just to smile with a person, Allahu Akbar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards you for free of charge. In other words, you never have to do any hard work to get rewarded. Allah rewards you just to beautify yourself, to make others feel nice, to make yourself feel good. At the same time, remember, a lot of people would say in today's time that if you smile, you actually add on years to your lifespan. Allah knows when you leave this world. But according to scientists and so forth, if you smile more often, you'll actually put on years onto your lifespan. So the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke to us some 1,400 years ago about how to smile with people, how to talk to people. And remember, to smile with a Muslim brother is a form of sadaqah, a form of charity. Now remember, this was what made the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a perfect example, a leader. He was a leader. At the end of the day, remember, he was a father, he was a husband, he was أفضل الخلق, the greatest of creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وأكرم الرسل, the most honored amongst the Anbiya alayhim as-salam, and yet he was a leader. When he came home, he was a father, and he was a husband, and he was a friend to others. Yet he was the greatest of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation to walk on this earth. But what made the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a fine example? When his wife Aisha radiallahu anha was asked, what was the character of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Subhanallah, she mentioned, do you not read the Quran? كان خلقه القرآن. His character was the Quran al-Kareem. He was a walking Quran, in other words. Now remember, if the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam basically saw an act which opposed the deen, he would reprimand it in a manner which was suitable. He went and reprimanded us in a manner which was suitable. Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu an, once he actually mentioned, subhanallah, that the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw a man wearing a gold ring. So he reached for it and removed it. And he then said that, would one of you seek a burning charcoal and place it on his hand? The man was later told, after the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left, that take off your ring, because this, subhanallah, in Islam, the man, basically Islam and, you know, men cannot wear gold. And this was narrated by Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those that will stay away from things which the Quran and Hadith have prohibited us from staying away. Taking a quick break, inshallah, stay tuned.
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب. لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب.
Welcome back. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum. Yes, alhamdulillah, before the break, we were speaking about the character of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What kind of fine example he was, how he led, how he spoke to people in the same manner we spoke about, subhanallah, that Islam being such a way of life that speaks about every action or every aspect of one's life. From the time we are created till the time we leave this world. Now remember, you know, it's we as human being, when we are born, Adam alayhi salam was created from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he was taught by Allah everything. وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we taught Adam alayhi salam, Adam, the names of everything, meaning, هذا حجر, هذا شجر. This is a mountain, or this is a stone, this is a tree, هذا جبل, this is a mountain, and so forth, etc., etc. But we as creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sons of Adam alayhi salam, It's we are when we are born. Does a child know what's good for him or bad for him? No. It's the parents who inculcate into the child what he or she knows. So when a child is born, for example, does that child know what's, you know, how does scolding taste like? Never. He doesn't know that, you know, this thing that tastes nice and so forth, etc. It's you as the mother or father or the guardian of the child who inculcates into this child what he or she knows. But at the same time, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Adam alayhi salam the names of everything. We as creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we learn things. But we have Islam that came to us to teach us everything in our life. The Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Remember, like we normally say, that our bodies are a machine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the Quran and the hadith being the words of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for those that don't believe in the hadith, remember, if you don't believe in the hadith, you don't believe in the Quran. Because the Quran al-Kareem says, وَمَا يُنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ أو Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whatever you utter from your mouth is but divine revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in other words, the hadith is the comment of the Quran al-Kareem. Now, our bodies are like a machine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it such that when you go tomorrow and buy a machine from somebody or a company, and from the company, they have an instruction manual with the machine. The Quran al-Kareem is our instruction manual. And from the company, they send somebody to show you how to use this machine via the instruction manual. Physically, in other words. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the example that came unto us to show us how to use this machine via the Quran al-Kareem in the hadith. So in other words, he was a living example of the Quran al-Kareem. He came to us to show us how to use the Quran al-Kareem and the hadith so that we may have a life of salvation, you know, ila Jannah, inshallah, to the path of Jannah. Ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every Nabi that came to this world came with the same example, la ilaha illallah. There is no God but Allah, and I am the prophet of this era. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with the same message that remember, I command to worship one Allah alone, and I am the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bunya al-Islam ala khamsin. Islam has been built upon five pillars. Shahadati an la ilaha illallah. To testify that there is no God but Allah. Wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. This is the first. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being the messenger of God. Wa iqam al-salah. To keep steadfast in salah. Wa ita'i al-zakah. To give the alms or the charity. Wa siyami Ramadan. To fast in the month of Ramadan. Wa hajj al-bayt. And to make pilgrim of the Baytullah. And to make hajj. إِنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. If we have the means, the ability to do so. Now coming back to the akhlaq of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his character, Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu anhu once also, subhanallah, he says that the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that whoever of you sees an evil action, like we mentioned earlier on, مَنْ رَأَى مِنْكُمْ مُنْكَرًا فَلْيُغَيِّرْهُ بِيَدِهِ. Which whoever of you sees an evil action, let him change it with his hand. If this is not possible, or if he's not able to do so, then with his tongue, with his mouth, speak out against it. If this is not possible as well, then with his heart. With his heart meaning that he should think of it in the heart as an evil act. And this is the lower form of Iman, Rawahu Muslim. At the same time, when it came to spending generously, Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu once says that the Nabi of Allah, now remember viewers out there, we are speaking about the sublime conduct of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Generosity, how to speak to people. Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu says the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, subhanallah, was never ever asked for something when a person accepted Islam. Except that he granted that person whatever this person asked for. Allahu Akbar. A man came to the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once and said, Ya Rasulullah, you know, I want such and such. The Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clearly gave it to him. Another man came to the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah. And he gave him a herd of sheep that was grazing between the two mountains. Subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This was his character, his generosity. The man returned to his people and said, Wallahi, O my people. Wallahi, O my people. Accept Islam in Muhammad. Take shahari in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as messenger of Allah. Oh my people, ya ayyuhan nas. First, ittaqillah, fear Allah. And secondly, bring Islam in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives out generously, like one who does not fear poverty. Rawahu Muslim. Muslim narrates as well. So just imagine going to his people. You are going to a certain person. You know what? They vote for this party. These people give out like no man's business. They don't fear. They don't want to eat. They want to give back to the people. Vote for these people. Have faith in these people. This man comes to his people. Ya ayyuhan nas, O my people. Believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This man gives like there's no tomorrow. Or this man gives like he does not fear poverty. Why? Tawakkalna ala Allah. We rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And remember, as the hadith mentions for those viewers out there, that if you give and your wealth might become less, then remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will feed you like He feeds the birds. If you rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala solely, Allah will feed you as He feeds the birds. Going out in the morning, seeking sustenance, and come back at night with a full tummy. Allahu Akbar. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, subhanallah, one of the famous Sahaba, also once mentioned, subhanallah, that the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the most generous. He was the most generous of people, and more so during the month of Ramadan when he met Jibril. He would meet him every night during the month of Ramadan to practice and review the Quran with him. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so generous that he was faster than a swiftest wind in this regard. Rawahu al-Bukhari. So remember, Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam possessed all these qualities. When it came to justice, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ. In fairness, Allah commands you to do good and be just. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم صل على نبينا محمد وعلى آل نبينا محمد وبارك وسلم. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى peace and salutation be upon our noble master Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He was a man who was just and fair in every aspect of his life, whether it came to his ashab, to his companions, to his wives, everything, and the application of deen. Aisha radiallahu anha once, subhanallah, Sayyida Aisha, she mentions that the people of Quraysh were extremely concerned about a certain Makhzumi woman. A woman from a certain tribe of the Makhzum, the Bani Makhzum, who committed a theft. And they conversed among themselves and said, you know what, that who can intercede on her behalf with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, talking among themselves. And they finally said, who dares to speak to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this matter except Usama bin Zayd radiallahu anhu, the most beloved young man to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Usama spoke to the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about what regarding the woman from the Makhzum tribe. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Wallahi ya Usama, do you intercede on their behalf to disregard one of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's basically ahkam or commands? And the Messenger of Allah said, get up. He got up himself and delivered a speech saying, people, before you were destroyed, because when the noble, amongst them stole, remember, they would let him go. And the poor and weak stole, they would basically punish this person. By Allah, uqsimu billahi al-azim. أقسم بالله العظيم if Fatima, the daughter of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم stole, I would cut her hand. So remember, when it came to justice, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم was just and fair. and allowed others to avenge themselves, even if it harmed themselves, basically. And a man from the Ansar was cracking jokes with the people and making them, you know, laugh and sitting, you know, going for themselves, in other words. And the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed by them. And he said by the side lightly, and he spoke to them. The man exclaimed, "Ya Rasulullah, allow me to avenge myself." The Nabi of Allah said, "Go ahead." Subhanallah. The man said, "Oh Rasulullah, you are wearing a garment and I was not there when you basically poked me or you jabbed at him. So basically, it's only fair that I do the same to you." The Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, subhanallah, raised his upper garment to expose his side, and the Ansar merely kissed him. He kissed the Nabi of Allah. And this person said, "Wallahi ya Rasulullah, I only meant to do this, O Messenger of God." Rawahu Abu Dawud. But this was the love that the Sahabi had for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The incident here, or the lesson that we learn from this, the ibrah, is that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he done this to this person told him, "I'm taking revenge, I'm avenging myself. Let me poke you back. Let me poke at you. Let me point at you. By all means, go ahead." In today's time, poke at somebody and he tells you, "I will poke back at you." What you'll say? "Do you know me? Do you know who I am? I come from such and such person. Or you know such and such person. I hang around with this person here." Wallahi, it's all becoming a big circus. Kibr. Al-kibriya awridai. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remember, pride belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us just. As he commands, "Inna Allah ya'murukum bil 'adl wal ihsan." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you to do good and be fair and be just. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those, inshaAllah. We'll leave it there for tonight. Just to inform all those viewers out there, if you want to like our Facebook page, you can do so at Hamaad Timol, or you can follow us on our Twitter account at Hamaad 6, HAMMAAD, the number 6. From myself, Hamaad Timol, inshaAllah. Until we meet again, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب ما كان حديثا يفترى ولكن تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل كل شيء وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون.